Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever unto ages of ages.
Amen.
In peace let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Let us commend ourselves and each other all our life unto Christ.
Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our Lord.
To thee, O Lord.
For thou art a good God and lovest mankind, and unto thee do we send up glory, to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
In the beginning, Domine Verbum Dei, O Lord.
Epistle of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brethren, we are God's co-workers, you are God's field, God's building. According to God's grace, which has been given to me as a wise builder, I lay the foundation and another builds upon it. But let everyone be careful how he builds upon it. For other foundation no one can lay, but that which has been laid, which is Jesus the Christ. But if anyone builds upon this foundation with gold, silver, gems, wood, hay, straw, the work of each one shall be made manifest. For the Lord's day shall declare it, because it shall be revealed in fire, and the work of each man, whoever he be, shall be assayed in fire. If the work any man built on the foundation stands, he shall receive a reward. If anyone's work burns down, he shall suffer its loss, yet he himself shall be saved, though only by passing, so to speak, through fire. Do you not know that you are God's temple, and that God's Spirit lives in you? If anyone destroys this temple of God, God will destroy him. For holy is God's temple, and this holy temple you are.
Wisdom,
the Alleluia, the Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia,
get into the boat and cross the sea ahead of him while he dismissed the crowd. And when he had dismissed the crowd, he went up the mountain alone to pray. And when it was late, he was there alone, but the boat was in the midst of the sea, buffeted by the waves, for the wind was against them. But in the fourth watch of the night, Jesus came to them, walking upon the sea. And the disciples, seeing him walk upon the sea, were greatly alarmed, and exclaimed, "It is a ghost!" And they cried out for fear. Then Jesus immediately spoke to them, saying, "Take courage. courage, it is I. Do not be afraid. But Peter answered him and said, Lord, if it is you, order me to come to you over the water. And he said, come. Then Peter got out of the boat and walked on the water to come to Jesus. But when he saw the strong wind, he was afraid. And as he began to sink, he cried out, saying, Lord, save me. And Jesus at once stretched out his hand and took hold of him, saying to him, O you of little faith, why did you doubt? And when they got into the boat, the wind fell. But those who were in the boat came and worshipped him, saying, Truly, you are the Son of God. And crossing over, they came to the land of Gennesaret.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to
Like Psalm 145 that we do every Divine Liturgy, I was struck by the part where it says, I will praise the Lord as long as I live. I will sing praises to my God while I have being. I'm on alive. Why I have the opportunity. And here we walk into the Divine Liturgy, and we have this opportunity to praise God with all of our being. Okay, and so this means that we're called to put all of ourself into this, our whole being, our heart, our mind, our soul, everything that is us, into this Divine Liturgy. And so our Lord, he came to the disciples during the storm, okay, and he comes to us in this Divine Liturgy, so that we, in this Divine Liturgy, coming to him where there's a relative calm, will be able, from all that we gain from the Divine Liturgy, to be able to come to him during the storms as well. Sometimes even we come into the Divine Liturgy with storms going on, you know, in our hearts and our consciousness. But always the Lord is there. That's why he says, do not be afraid, do not fear, come to me. Come to me. He was just says, you know, it says here in the gospel, there's one word he says, come. Come. And of course, to come, it does take courage, because we have to come out of ourselves. See, like, what happens is we turn just here and grab on to ourselves, and that always fails. Always fails. The revelation of Jesus Christ to us is that he is our Savior. We are not our Savior. So Peter and the apostles are in the boat, and a big storm comes up, and, you know, here comes the Lord, and Peter first, you know, gets out there, okay, but then stumbles because he takes his eyes off of Christ. His heart doesn't stay focused on Christ. His mind doesn't stay in the mind of Christ, and so he starts to sink. Oh, you have little faith. You have little faith. Little faith, okay, means I'm going to cling just to myself to work all this out instead of coming out and being with him. And you know, in this Divine Liturgy, Jesus is all over the place. He is here. He is present. He is saying, now come, be not afraid. Come out of self. Come out of clinging to all this stuff that holds us back. To knowing him, to loving him, to serving him, to entering into this tremendous communion that's offered to us in this Divine Liturgy, the whole thing. And so when we come in this door right away, we should be trying to wake up and during the whole divine liturgy, to trying to wake up. As I said to our community, I was at Holy Protection Monastery up in Upper Michigan a while back, with the Eastern Catholic Monastery, and I was very impressed, you know, by the monks there. They were very hard, you know, in just surviving. And yet, when they come in to pray, these guys are rooted down, you know, into faith. And they've been through enough, you know, to like say, we don't got much else to depend on but Jesus. We only have Jesus. And because of this, they let go of all this other stuff, and boom, they're down into the prayer. You know, they're walking on the water within their temple, within their chapel. You know, we should be walking on the water here, because Christ is all around us. He's everywhere present and filling all things. The Holy Spirit's here. The Father's here. The Trinity is just pulsating within these four walls if we come out of ourselves and listen to the word. Come. He says a couple times in here, do not be afraid. It's hard not to be afraid to take this step. You know, take this step into the life of the Holy Trinity. But we're not going to drown. When we do it, we're not going to drown. He guarantees us we won't drown. We might die, humanly speaking. So what? We die into the fullness of God. That's why he's being out of faith. So, brothers and sisters, for the rest of this divine liturgy, the rest of it, come out. Walk on the water. Come, he says. Come, he says. Come. Be not afraid.
Let us all say with all our soul and with all our mind, let us say,
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord Almighty, that all of our fathers we pray thee hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to thy great mercy, we pray thee hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Again we pray for our Metropolitan Salutary, for all priests, deacons, and all of the clergy, and for all our brethren in Christ.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Again we pray for this country, its president, for all civil authorities, and for the armed forces.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Again we pray for the blessed and ever memorial holy Orthodox patriarchs, the blessed and ever memorial founders of this holy monastery, for all our fathers and brethren, for the Orthodox departed this life before us, who healed and all the world by sleep in the Lord.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Again we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, and visitation for the servants of God, for the brethren of this holy temple, for the pardon and remission of their sins.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Who bring offerings and do good works in this holy and all venerable temple, for those who labor and those who sing, for all the people here present who await thy great and rich mercy.
Lord, have mercy, have mercy.
For thou art a merciful God and lovest man.
to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom, that guarded always by thy might, and may send up glory to thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever unto ages of ages.
Amen. Let us move
princes, the archbishops all the time, all the priests, even sons, and Buddhists and sisters, all the married couples, their children, and grandchildren, all the late day from the Archdiocese of San Francisco, now and ever and ages of ages.
Amen.
Lord God, remember this kingdom, all those who are prayers, now and ever and ages of ages.
Amen.
Lord God, remember this kingdom, ever young, pray for over all healing, now and ever and ages of ages.
Amen.
Lord God, for daughter's graces, Veronica, for all she does for us, now and ever and ages of ages.
Amen.
Lord God, remember this kingdom, Pauline and John, as they just celebrated their 50th wedding anniversary. May God reward them for their faithfulness and a long time love for each other, now and ever and ages of ages.
Amen.
May Lord God, remember his kingdom, all your Orthodox Christians, both now and forever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Unto all
and to your spirit.
Lord of Sabaoth.
Master, who lovest mankind, we also cry aloud and say, Holy art thou and all holy, thou the only begotten Son and thy Holy Spirit. Holy art thou and all holy, and magnificent is thy glory, who hast so loved the world as to give thine only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but everlasting life. Who, when he had come and fulfilled all the dispensation for us, in the night in which he was given up, or rather gave himself up for the life of the world, took bread in his holy, most pure, and blameless hands, and when he had given thanks, and blessed it, and hallowed it, and broken it, he gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, Take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you, for the remission of sin. And likewise, after supper, he took the cup, saying, Drink of it, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the remission of sin. Resurrection on the third day, the ascension to heaven, the sitting at the right hand, and the second and glorious coming. We offer unto thee thine of thine own on behalf of all and for all. Make this bread the precious body of thy Christ. And that which is in this cup, the precious blood of thy Christ. Making the change by thy holy who partake the vigilance of soul, for the remission of sins, for the communion of thy Holy Spirit, for the fulfillment of the kingdom of heaven, for boldness towards thee and not for judgment or condemnation, Again, we offer thee this rational worship for those who have fallen asleep in the faith, ancestors, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, ascetics, and every righteous spirit made perfect in faith. Especially for our most holy, most pure, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotoka, and ever Virgin Mary.
It is true.
Let us ask the Lord.
God is, O Lord.
All things that are good and profitable
our souls and peace for the world, let us ask the Lord.
Gratis, O Lord.
That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask the Lord.
Gratis, O Lord.
For a Christian end to our life, painless, blameless, and peaceful, and a good defense before the dread judgment seat of Christ, let us ask the Lord.
Gratis, O Lord.
For the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and each other in all our life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
And make us worthy, O Master, that with boldness and without condemnation we may dare call thee the heavenly God as Father, and to say,
Our Father, who art in
and compassion and love toward mankind, of thy only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with an all holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Thank you.
that thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God, who came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am first. I believe also that this is truly thine own most beloved, and that this is truly thine own precious blood. Therefore I pray thee, have mercy upon me. Forgive my transgressions, both voluntary and involuntary, of word and of deed, committed in ignorance and ignorance, and make me worthy to partake without condemnation of thy most pure mysteries, for the remission of my sins, and unto life everlasting. Amen. Of thy mystical supper, O Son of God, accept me today as a communicant, for I will not speak of thy mystery to thy enemies, neither like Judas will I give thee a kiss, but like the thief will I confess thee. Remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom. May the communion of thy holy mysteries be neither to my judgment nor to my condemnation, O Lord, but to the healing of soul and mind.
Praise him in the highest.
please just bend down a little bit, put your head all the way back, and just open your mouth. Don't stick out your tongue. In the fear of God, with faith and love, draw near.
Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord. The Lord is God and has revealed himself to us.
Save thy people and bless thine inheritance.
We have seen the true Lord. We have received the heavenly Spirit. We have found the true faith, worshiping your divine Trinity, who has saved us.
partaken of the divine, holy, most pure, immortal, heavenly, life-giving and dread mysteries of Christ, let us worthily give thanks unto the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Asking that the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us commend ourselves and each other and our life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
For our sanctification, unto thee do we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us depart in peace.
In the name of the Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, bless those who bless thee and sanctify those who trust in thee. Save thy people and bless thy inheritance. Preserve the fullness of thy church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of thy house. Glorify them in return by thy divine power, and forsake us not to put our hope in thee. Give peace to thy world, to thy churches, to thy priests, to all those in civil authority, to the armed forces, and to all thy people. For every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from thee, the Father of lights. And unto thee do we send up glory, thanksgiving, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord, henceforth and forevermore. Blessed be the name of the Lord, henceforth and forevermore. Blessed be the name of the Lord, henceforth and forevermore.
Christ our true God, through the prayers of his most pure mother, of the holy, glorious, and all laudable apostles, of our Father, Mother, Saints John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, of Saint Joseph the Provider, of Saint Anne, the Mother of the Mother of God, whose memory we keep this day, of the holy, righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anne again, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us for his good and loves all mankind.
Glory be to thee, O God, glory be to thee, O God, glory be to thee, O God. I thank thee, O Lord my God, for thou didst not reject me a sinner, but deem me worthy to be a partaker of thy holy mysteries. I thank thee that despite my unworthiness, thou mayest be worthy to receive thy most pure and heavenly gifts. O Master, lover of mankind, thou didst die and rise for our sake, and favored us with thee, thine awesome and life-giving mysteries, for the benefit and sanctification of our souls and bodies. Grant that they may be for the healing of my soul and body, and for the rout of every adversary, for the enlightenment of the eyes of my heart, for the peace of my spiritual powers, for an undaunted faith and unfeigned love, the fullness of wisdom, the keeping of thy commandments, growth in thy divine grace, and for belonging to thy kingdom, in order that, preserved by them in thy holiness, I may always remember thy love, and no longer live for myself, but for thee, our Master and Benefactor. Thus, when I depart from this life in the hope of life eternal, may I attain that everlasting rest, where the sound of those celebrating never ceases, and where there is no end, to the delight of those who behold the ineffable beauty of thy face. For thou art the true goal of our desire, and the indescribable gladness of those who love thee, O Christ our God. And all creation sing thy praises forever. Amen.
Christ, our Master and God, King of all of ages and Creator of all, I thank thee for all the blessings thou hast given me, and for the reception of thine immaculate and life-giving mysteries. I pray thee, therefore, O good lover of mankind, keep me under thy protection in the shadow of thy wings. Grant that with a pure conscience until my last breath, I may worthily partake of thy holy mysteries for the forgiveness of sins and for the life everlasting. For thou art the bread of life, the fountain of holiness, and the bestower of good things. To thee we render glory together with the Father and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, unto ages of ages. Amen.
Most Holy Lady, Mother of God, light of my darkened soul, my hope, my protection, my refuge, my comfort, and my joy. I am thankful that thou enablest me, unworthy as I am, to become a partaker of the immaculate body and precious blood of thy Son. Oh,
without condemnation until my last breath. The immaculate and sanctifying mysteries for the healing of my soul and body. Grant me tears of repentance and thanksgiving, so that I may sing and glorify thee all the days of my life. For thou art blessed and glorified forever. Amen. Give the blessing, Father, in the name of the Lord.
Christ, our true God, to the prayers of his most pure mother, our venerable God, bring forth, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for his good and loves man.